Welcome. In this video, we will walk you through the error codes and their fixes for the PWM-SQ solar controller. This video applies to both the 10 and 30 amp models. PO1 error. A PO1 error indicates a polarity reverse error from the solar panel. In this case, either the negative wire has been applied to the positive post of the controller, or there is a connection issue between the solar panel on the roof and the solar controller. Check the solar input for a negative voltage at the controller with a multimeter. If you don't have one, any hardware store should carry multimeters. If it shows a negative voltage, the polarity is incorrect and should be reversed. PO2 error. A PO2 error indicates the solar voltage coming into the controller exceeds 26.5 volts. This would be the max voltage the controller can handle. If this error occurs, check the output of the solar panel with a multimeter to determine if it is sized correctly for the controller. If your solar panel or panels produce more amps than the controller will handle, you will need to upgrade your controller or reconfigure your solar array. If the error persists, check your panel wiring to make sure the panels are not wired incorrectly. Panels wired in series to the controller effectively double the solar voltage to the controller. BO1 error. The controller requires power from the battery for it to operate. If you have a BO1 error, this indicates a low battery voltage at the solar controller. First, make sure your batteries are fully charged, because if the batteries are low, this would be a normal error to occur. If the batteries are not low and the BO1 error is still showing, then there could be a wiring issue. To remedy a wiring issue, check your battery and terminal block connections to ensure they are properly connected. If your wiring is good, the next step is to determine if you have 12 volts at the controller. Using a multimeter, measure the input from the battery directly on the back of the controller. If there is no voltage, the inline fuse on the positive solar line could be blown. Check the fuse and replace if necessary. If you complete these steps and your controller is still showing the error, perform a hard reset. Performing a hard reset. To perform a hard reset on the SQ controller, first, dismount it from the RV wall. Second, disconnect or unscrew the positive and negative ports for both the solar panel and battery. This will leave your solar controller completely disconnected from your panel and battery. Wait for 45 minutes before reconnecting the four ports as shown. Make sure the wires do not come into contact with each other while waiting. BO2 error. A BO2 error indicates a polarity reverse error from the battery. In this case, the negative wire has been applied to the positive post of the controller, and the positive wire has been applied to the negative post. Ensure the wires are in the correct position, which is normally red wire to positive and black to negative. Sometimes an installer may have added other wire colors. If this is the case, you will need to determine where the reverse polarity issue is using a multimeter. This will allow you to see which wire is positive and which wire is negative. A negative voltage will indicate a reverse polarity. BO3 error. A BO3 error indicates an overcharge issue at the battery. To remedy this, first measure the battery's voltage with a multimeter. Do not refer to your controller's screen as valid information while it is in this state. If your battery's measure is overcharged, which depends on the battery chemistry, then a charging source is putting too much current to the battery. From here, there will be a bit of detective work to determine which source is overcharging your battery. It could be the solar controller, the alternator, or the converter charger. There have been instances where the solar wires have been placed in the battery connections on the solar controller. The BO3 error code would show in this instance as well. Check on the back of the controller with a multimeter to confirm the charging sources. If it has been wired incorrectly, swap the wires to the correct position. There are labels on the back of the controller to indicate the correct positions. If you complete these steps and your controller is still showing the error, contact GoPower Technical Support for additional steps. Contact info is included in the description below.